everyone, welcome back to my channel. Make sure you subscribe below because I'm uploading several times a week so you never miss out on exciting new content. So the Paris Hilton documentary. Guys, if you haven't seen it, I really recommend watching it. Authentic, compelling, and quite touching, to be honest. Now, the first instinct after watching was immediately for me to take the side of the victims. I myself suffered violence when I was a child. I'm probably still dealing with some of the emotional consequence, but I was also once or twice where the parents were. I know what that feels like when you have no control or influence over your child or stepchild, so much so that you're actually considering sending them away to some behavioral boot camp and have someone else deal with them for a moment. What is the solution? I don't want to see any kid become a victim to either domestic violence or institutional violence. I heard other frustrated parents saying, oh, well, we can't spank them into shape ourselves. We can't send them off to be disciplined somewhere else. What do we do? Parents are lost. How do we get our spoiled, over-entitled children to do what we say? So here's the solution. We first need to understand three key points, and we need to get them into our head. One, control is an illusion. We need to realize once and for all that we have no control whatsoever over our children's choices. They are their own, and that is true from the moment they are born. So what do we have? Influence. Yes, we cannot and should not try to control our kids, but we can and should make an impact on their lives by positively influencing them. And in a minute, we're going to talk about how to be positive influence in our child's life. But first, we're going to go to key point number two. Our children are no different than any other human being around us. They deserve an equal treatment to the one we give others and expect them to give to us. I keep hearing parents say, oh, my kids, you know, they're a piece of work. No one drives me crazier than my own kids. They get the worst out of me. But at the same time, treat their kids in ways that they would never dare to treat their friends, their colleagues, another member of the family, or their employee. You want to know how to get the best out of your child? Speak to them like you would to a promising student or to your employee. You may be the boss, but you can't force them into being productive. Which takes us to point number three. With children, it's all about intent. Because children's brains are not fully developed yet, they have amazing sensors, and they learn about the world from sensing rather than understanding. So we can sit and talk here about what to do with them and how to do it, but at the end of the day, we have to truly mean what we say and then be able to follow up on what we said by action. And of course, to avoid emotional manipulation. So if kids see us say one thing and mean another, promise one thing and do another, or say things in order to get something out of them, there goes the trust. So what can we do as parents to help build that trust with our kids and hopefully pave the way for them to be the best possible versions of themselves? And the answer is, tum-ta-dum, we give them our heart. Now, yes, a heart usually symbolizes love, and we all love our children. But what are the components of love? Let's break down what's inside that heart. H for honesty, E for empathy, A for attention, R for respect, and T for time. Let's expand a little bit about each one of those components. So we're going to start with honesty. We sometimes try to tell our children a better story than what reality actually is, because we either don't want to disappoint them or we don't want to scare them. But there are ways to tell the truth to a child at almost any age and about almost anything. Honesty is also tricky because in order to be honest with our children, we first have to be able to be fully honest with ourselves. If you're trying the best that you can to be honest with your child, but at the same time, you're lying to yourself about something you haven't been able to fully deal with, the child will pick up on the vibe of the dissonance, and then you're in a pickle. Instead of sugarcoating it, I would recommend to ask for professional advice on how to do it right. Moving on to E for empathy. The ability to put yourself in someone else's shoes and share and contain their emotions, even if you don't understand them. And that's before you react from your own point of view. Many times we tend to look down upon children's emotions. From our own adult point of view, we see them as insignificant or illegitimate. But if we want our child trust, we have to be able to put ourselves in their shoes at their age and react compassionately, because things that may not matter to us may matter a lot to them in their little world, in their little heads, and in their little hearts. And because children operate mostly based on emotions, showing empathy to how they feel when they try to express those emotions, as silly as they may look to you, goes a long way in showing them that we care. We're moving on to A. A for attention. Now, we all know that children need our attention. That's an obvious one. But it's important within attention that we emphasize the intent, meaning that giving our children attention is not exclusive to spending physical time with them. We can be physically with them, but intellectually or emotionally, we can be somewhere completely different, which will, in our kids' point of view, miss the mark. When a child comes over with something that they drew or built and they really wanted to show us, we can actually stop what we're doing completely and just look at the photo or at the thing, just put as much emotion as possible into our response. Wow, you built that yourself. I love it. It's really cool. What does it do? For that 1 minute, it can literally take 1 minute, but be 100% concentrated on them and give them that uninterrupted attention. And that condensed attention from you is sometimes all they want. And that goes a long way and means the world to them. Next, we're moving to R for respect. So we mentioned respect earlier. We must treat our children as people. They may be smaller and less capable or less in control than us, but they still deserve the same amount of human respect as we would show another adult or as we would expect from them to show us. And lastly, it's T for time. So we mentioned that attention is not exclusively related to physical time, and yet giving away some of our time to spend uniquely with our children is really, really key. So while we always want to show our children honesty, empathy, attention, and respect, those can all be really amplified and strengthened when we also set aside the time that is dedicated to them, either a one-on-one or as a joint family time, when we can really hear what they're going through, show our care, be interested in one another, and not be dealing with anything else at that time that we dedicated for them. Thanks again for listening. That was my extended philosophy on building the best relationship possible, in my eyes, with our children or future children. I realize that everyone's point of view is different. Feel free to always leave those in the comments. In the meantime, if you haven't watched the film, make sure you watch it. It's called the Paris Hilton documentary. It's available on YouTube, and I'm going to put the link to it below in the description. Apart from that, make sure to subscribe and give us a little like if you like the content, and I'll see you soon on the next vlog.